All right, I'm really a big fan of that track, and I don't know why, because it doesn't do much, but I guess I'm just a sucker for subtlety. And it's a really nice mix from Children, honestly. It's got a similar groove. I'm back, though, and we're going to pick the energy level way up. Here comes the track Keep On Dancing by Kaztek. 10 bonus points if you can identify what it samples. Hey, Football Sven. Welcome to the stream, Football Sven. Welcome to the stream, Cynthia. Remember, I take requests. Does anyone have any requests? So, Crayon, you said you speak French. Are you from French Canada or France? Or I guess I should leave the option open, like you're from one of the like two or three Caribbean islands that speak French. And where are you at? By the way, this is sampling Hella Good by No Doubt with Gwen Stefani. Yeah, sure, Steve, what's your request? What's your request, RW Bladewing? Really?
Let's go. We'll be right back.
no tomorrow.
All right, that last track, I shouldn't even have to say this. That last track was the theme to the 80s failed video game, Cheetah Men. RW Bladewing can tell you all about that. Now this is the Jesse Bloke bootleg of Gary Jules' Mad World. And coming up next, Football's Ven requests Ryan NZ My Demise, and I have it. I don't have that one, I'm sorry. Welcome to the stream, Dez. Thank you, Boombox. I knew there was a reason your character was still alive in our Battle Brothers playthrough. By the way, I don't know if they're watching, but I'd like to congratulate some new names in the chat down here this week, or in the patron list. Loki is a new patron, which is awesome. Also, Anthony, if you're watching, you're a recent patron. We appreciate our patrons here. Okay, that last track, that was Felix Cartel with Tonight. This is Metrum by Fetty LeGrand. And we're not even halfway through this stream yet. We go till midnight, East Coast US time. That are dropping. Thank you for the follow, Crayhen. We really appreciate it here. The beats that are rocking, the bombs that are dropping, the people that are following, the beats that are rocking, the bombs that are dropping. How about having, not just hype, having exactly the precise mix of the precise song of a request hype? Those spruke gifts hit. I think the last one was Tiny Tempa. I don't know. Hey, for those of y'all who are new to the stream, you know you can type spruke gif anything to summon an animated gif of that thing, or the internet's best guess. It works intermittently, as most things that I code myself do. 100%, Dez. 100%. Just get me the dates. As long as it's not May 26th, I'm already at Seneca Niagara Casino then. Also, there's one day in July that I'm at Buffalo Creek. Just let me know. And tell me what the playlist needs to be. If y'all want this, or if y'all want something else. I'm flexible. I aim to please. And also, let me know the hours, the pay, and if I can get cheap food comped. Crayhen, try again. I don't know, Terry Pagula, you'd have to come to Bottoms Up the night I played there. Would love to meet the owner of the Bills and the Sabres. See you again soon, Crayhen. Hey, I have an unresponded comment from earlier. I think it was Chainlinks said that they were looking into my diet. I'm gonna shift to a less exciting track for a minute so that I can talk over it, because I have a couple words about the diet for Chainlinks. I really do advise this diet heavily. So let me just finish this mix. This is Make Them Bounce Like a Trampoline by DeLayers, which kind of annoys me. Because you want to make them bounce like people on a trampoline. The trampoline doesn't bounce. The trampoline is stationary.
can probably make them bounce like a trampoline. Jump, 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 jump.
A rare series of successes from spruke. All right, so chain links, you still there? So I've been on the slow carb diet for about 8 months and lost 25 pounds. I'm not done yet. I'd still like to lose like 5 more, but I'm almost at my ideal size. And for those of y'all who don't know, the slow carb diet is almost a no carb diet, but the idea is to not have any carbs that trigger the blood sugar reflex cycle. So not the the glucose, glucagon, or glycogen, and then insulin response cycle, and it breaks your addiction to sugar. So it's really weird. After a couple weeks, you stop getting interested in eating because without the feel reward of eating that comes from that blood sugar response cycle, you're just kind of indifferent. Of course, then it all comes back on cheat days. But the hardest thing to get used to is, like, look, nobody wants to cook every day, so it gets really hard to find places where you can eat okay, since wraps, sandwiches, burgers are all out, and also dairy is out, so, like, no cheese or milk. Okay. So you gotta start drinking your coffee black, stuff like that. Anyway, the one piece of advice I have is that the best place to get fast food is the mid-range Mexican chains. Qdoba, Moe's, Salsarita's, Chipotle, because you can get a plate full of beans, meat, fresh veggies, and guacamole. Just don't get any cheese or sour cream or rice, and it's still like a really good meal. Me and my wife basically live on Qdoba, so there's that advice. Okay, let's pick the energy level back up now that I'm done with my monologue. And if you decide to do it, Chainlinks, good luck. Cynthia, you still here? Hola, Cynthia, está aquí? All right, the next track is dedicated to Cynthia. Está próximo cantana, está por Cynthia. Nada. Viewer Chainlinks asks, do you have a favorite song or a favorite meal on cheat day? Yes and no. For my main meal of cheat day, it's my only chance. I only get one cheat day every week. And I've been in this diet for 8 months. So it's actually only a couple dozen chances to relive all my favorite meals, which is like, if 1 week I want to get my yearning for pasta out of my system, that's what I'm using Cheat Day on. And so, like, then next week I'm not going to do pasta again. I need to go cross something else off the list. The only shameful Cheat Day staple I have is that, this is so embarrassing. I really like to begin my cheat day with one of those Rolly Dog taquitos from the 7-Eleven at the corner. It's the junkiest junk food, but it's just like, it hits me with that, it hits me with the carbs, the cheese, the sauce, the sugar, the salt, all at once, and it's kind of really satisfying. So yes, I start the day off with the gross ass taquito, the Rolly Dog from the 7-Eleven. Okay, this one's dedicated to Terry Pegula. That one's so hard to pull off because they're actually in completely separate keys and at completely separate tempos. But it turns out that the amount that you slow the one down to make it the other's tempo changes the key the right amount too. So it's like a stroke of luck that it works. Okay, just double checking. Crayhen, you said your daughter is in bed, right? Because the next song is not safe for daughters or sons or whatever, but yeah. Doesn't say it in the track listing up here, but this is the Vision Factory remix, which puts the song at house music tempo instead of hip-hop tempo.
Don't want none unless you got funds, hun.
RB. I'm gonna leave you with a really nice remix of Pompeii by Bastille. It's the Audien remix. And yes, I was pushing the limits of the spruke gif there. I was hoping to get some stock photography of like people making salad.
About this, how am I gonna be an optimist about this? as you are. But if you close your eyes.